Magnesium bisglycinate, or more commonly known as magnesium glycinate, is considered to be one of the most well-tolerated forms of magnesium on the market. It's also one of the most absorbable forms of magnesium and one that is less likely to cause digestive or laxative effects thanks to the glycine group attached to it. And each day, the body loses magnesium due to normal processes like sweating, hormonal changes, as well as healthy kidney function. So it's important for everyone to keep tabs on this mineral in the body that's responsible for being a cofactor in more than 300 enzyme systems in the body. In this video, we will talk about what makes magnesium bisglycinate unique, what it specifically targets, the dosing for it, and end off with a few safety tips that you should definitely know of when it comes to taking magnesium in general. So stay with me until the end. Also, guys, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more videos just like this one. Magnesium is a mineral found in foods such as beans, seeds, and vegetables, and it's also the second most abundant mineral in the human body. Some of the highest sources come from cooked spinach, squash, and pumpkin seeds. It helps us to support healthy blood sugar control, proper nerve function, and a balanced stress response, as well as blood pressure maintenance and many other essential processes. I actually made a video on every type of magnesium supplement that I highly encourage you to watch after this one. And I will say that although it is possible to meet all your magnesium needs through just your diet alone, some people do require supplemental magnesium to meet their daily needs and maintain their optimal magnesium levels. And what is that level, you might ask? Well, it depends for some folks. I'll throw up a chart. The crazy part is almost half of the people in the US don't even get enough magnesium in a day. So keep these ranges in mind. It's recommended that adults take in between 310 milligrams and 420 milligrams of total magnesium per day, depending on age and being male or female and pregnant. And what makes magnesium bisglycinate so special is that firstly, it's highly bioavailable. And what does that mean exactly? Well, to put it simple, a large portion is able to enter your bloodstream and actually have an effect on your body. This is what makes it different from the other forms of magnesium. And one of the first well-known benefits is its role in improving insulin sensitivity in people with diabetes and in those at high risk for diabetes, including those with pre-diabetes. In 2021, you had a systematic review and meta-analysis of double-blind randomized control trials, 25 of them, which concluded that magnesium supplementation appears to have a beneficial role and improves glucose parameters in people with diabetes. The second well-known benefit is reducing high blood pressure levels. This is because when you maintain optimal magnesium status, the magnesium promotes the release of nitric oxide, which is a signaling molecule that helps relax blood vessels and maintain blood pressure. We have a pooled analysis of 24 randomized control trials with 1,325 type 2 diabetes individuals that revealed that subjects who received magnesium supplementation had statistically significant reductions in fasting plasma glucose, glycated hemoglobin, systolic blood pressure, and diastolic blood pressure. Those values were a drop of systolic of 7.69, and a drop of diastolic by 2.71 millimeters of mercury. The third benefit is its role on stress, anxiety, and depressive symptoms. There are a lot of studies that look at this, but a few that really tell you what's going on. The mechanism can be broken down into three pathways. The first is that magnesium influences activity of the hypothalamic pituitary adrenal axis, which instigates various responses to cope with stress demands. Secondly, magnesium also reduces central adrenal corticotrophic hormone and peripheral cortisol endocrine responses, thereby decreasing anxiety. Awesome. And lastly, magnesium may help reduce presynaptic glutamate release and glutamatergic activity that has been implicated in fear, anxiety, and panic responses. The fourth benefit I will add is for sleep. Magnesium binds to and increases the activity of receptors for GABA, a neurotransmitter responsible for sleep regulation. This will help reduce the excitability of the nervous system, which then promotes sleep. There's also some research that shows that people who have lower blood levels of magnesium tend to have poorer sleep quality compared to people with optimal magnesium levels. So if sleep is an issue, it's important to check your magnesium levels. The thing is, most of the time, you won't really notice any symptoms of short-term magnesium deficiency because the kidneys are already working to retain the magnesium when it's necessary. But those who are more prone to magnesium deficiency, or if you have GI issues like celiac or Crohn's, type 2 diabetes, eat lots of processed foods, elderly, and if you regularly drink alcohol. And in terms of the dosing for magnesium glycinate, 200 milligrams a day is the sweet spot, which comes in a pill, powder, or liquid form. And it's really important, guys, that you go with one that has undergone third-party testing from an independent laboratory. Some supplements are certified by organizations like UL, USP, and NSF International, which set strict standards for supplement quality and manufacturing safety. The one that is NSF certified and the one I appreciate is Thorne's Magnesium Bisglycinate. It's a powder formula that you mix one scoop, which is 200 milligrams. You mix it with 8 ounces of water and you'll get all the benefits that magnesium provides. Not to forget to mention Thorne's commitment to producing high quality and pure supplements from a team of experts that include physicians, researchers, and scientists who collaborate to develop scientifically backed formulations. In terms of safety tips, I highly recommend that you stay within the normal dosing range for magnesium and don't go overboard. Taking very high doses can lead to nausea, facial flushing, and stomach cramping, which we don't want. Also, guys, if you're currently on antibiotics or any other medications, you should consult with your doctor or pharmacist before taking magnesium glycinate. For example, taking way too much magnesium glycinate while you're on blood pressure medications could drop your blood pressure to a level that may cause you to pass out. And also, while a healthy kidney is capable of excreting excess magnesium, a damaged kidney may not have the same advantage. So those are a few instances where you want to get approval from your provider before taking it. Otherwise, magnesium glycinate is overall a very safe supplement when taken correctly. But I'm more curious to hear from you guys though. What are your thoughts on magnesium glycinate and magnesium as a whole? We'd love to read them down below. Also, if you found this video helpful, click the subscribe button and I'll see you guys on the next one.